Okay, the classroom is this way.
Yeah.
Are you guys doing your Ozobots this morning?
We are.
Oh, this is
making Ozobot balloon floats.
And their creativity, like, what is for these kiddos, right? Oh, where are they, like, really enjoying this activity? Well, like, where do you see them come to life?
Okay, so we're going to do a little mapping. We're working with Google Earth already. We're looking at Plymouth Plantation. We've looked at, actually been on the Mayflower. And what I'm hoping to do.
Did you bring me the fifth grade learning wheel?
These are first graders!
First graders.
Yeah,
first graders.
They love it.
So, how are you involving your virtual learners with this?
The virtual learners got things for me actually today. They got balloons, they got their little cups.
So what we did in August is our leadership team met, and I asked them their biggest focus, knowing that we had these challenges this year with just social distancing and making sure the safety was a priority. And they came up with three words. They wanted to make sure that they had classroom community. They wanted to make sure that they kept connections with their kids and that we preserved our culture here at River Ridge. And so we're doing this blended learning so that students can remain with their same peers and their same teacher all year, regardless of their educational setting.
As we're coming back, do we see some things that maybe we've picked up or we're keeping?
We did a lot of learning from each other as we would learn different tools, and we would share and have that collaboration time together.
And I think the biggest challenge, don't let it be on screen all them sitting together. That would cause...
It's in small chunks. They're wearing their masks. That's school.
We're trying to do school the best way we can.
Yes.
So we'll keep our social distancing where we can, keep on the mask, do the test before we get in here, wash our hands. It's a challenge.
It's hard, but they also want to collaborate and communicate with each other.
So we have a leader online. Carolyn, raise your hand. Our in-person kids are watching Carol as a leader. Our virtuals are watching Jason as a leader right now.
And now we see kids who are so comfortable in the classroom that are in person that go straight up to the computer and talk to their friends virtually.
Yeah.
And so it's so awesome.
That's
because they're
tremendous.
Showing them what's happening, or the kids that are at home have something that we don't have here, and they'll go and grab it from their closet or grab it from something and then bring it back to show us in our classroom.
Well, you know, my son does this. He goes and gets the cat and brings the cat to show the class.
Yes, exactly. They love their animals.
They do.
This is a third grade classroom. Language arts, and they are working collaboratively doing the blended learning model.
If you thought that in your head, I need you to floss it out. Ready? Go. Floss it out. Oh yeah. I thought that's what it would be in my summary. Woo-woo! Oh yeah. That's what I thought. Okay. All right.
So
let's check our summary.
Yes, counselor. Yeah, counselor. Do you want to talk to Christy? Do you want to talk a little bit about your drive bys? All right.
So we're doing something now called One School, One Book. The whole school will be reading a book. It's called Your Name is a Song. And so it's about the importance of our names and how important it is culturally.
Oh, that's great. It's very affirming for the students, right?
Yeah.
And then they get the diversity. They see how they're all part of a bigger picture. That's beautiful.
Because we really do. We have so many cultures here at River Ridge, and we just want to celebrate all of them. Mm-hmm. And it's interesting because I didn't even realize how many countries we have represented here. So it's over like 30.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Yes. I would imagine with a new environment that my thought would be is we'll just hunker down. Let's not try anything new. I love the fact that you're like, oh no, if we're gonna go try new things with the environment, we're gonna keep trying new projects.
Yeah.
This is awesome.
No, we're starting a lot of new initiatives because out of necessity, really. Because the biggest thing for us is making connections with kids.
Yeah.
And having those at home feel as connected as those here. So in order for that to happen, we're having to do a lot of things differently. Actually, I have a Google form and the parents can sign up, and I drive by their homes. So I've had probably, I don't know, over 30 home visits.
Wow.
And it's been really nice because sometimes those kids, they might not be struggling. They might just want to see a familiar face.
Yeah.
So I'll go spend 30 minutes at their house, and we wear our mask and we socially distance. But it's really nice because we're still making that connection.
Not only can you do it, it sounds like you're rocking it.
Well, you know what? There are some things that I think will continue.
Should we look at your book fair before we?
Yeah, that's really cool.
Yeah, you wanna look at that?
Oh, this is great.
Yeah, it's spaced out. It's we only have a few kids coming in here at a time.
This is awesome.
Yes. So we have like 10, about 10 kids that come at a time. Do you remember what it's called? When they look like comic books, but they're novels.
Graphic novel.
Graphic novel, good job.
Your virtual kiddos, are they staying connected?
We're trying. They're very good about messaging me if they have questions.
Okay.
Special team does our lessons asynchronously, so my lessons always drop on Mondays.
What are you going to do? What's your plans?
We're going to read a chapter and then we're going to talk about it.
They're still awesome and energized.
I know.
So cute.
It's so fun.
Oh my gosh.
School's happy.
Yeah.
It's a joyful place. I think that's the most important thing is that culture piece.
It is.
Right?
And the community that y'all created within the community, I mean, it's fabulous. What I got to see here today was even in an unusual circumstance. This district, this campus has really taken it on themselves and the leadership at this campus to say, how can we re-envision learning? And as a result, these teachers are excited, these kids are excited from everything from what we saw with the counseling, as you said, through the hybrid, through learning virtually and in person, the blended learning we see going on. There's a lot of excitement, a lot of reimagination, but a real focus on the whole child.